We were in a strange land. Under the earth, maybe. And we were not sure what to do. We would ask the people we would meet there, but first we would send out Joby to find us something nice. Hey there. We would find two colorful beetles. Pretty good. What would they do? Good for trading. Terrible for eating. All right. What else, though? What else would we have? What else could we leave behind, maybe? Certainly not the ancient tubing and the ancient engine. We had to find something else. So much, we had to throw away the earrings and the beetles. There was no way around it. Then we would go see the islanders. Seemed to be some kind of priest for the Pale Mask greeted us to their lands. The priest kept its hollow eyes focused on me as it told us that it expected our trek to develop a very close relationship to his tribe. They were friendly words, but there was something hollow about the way they emanated from behind the mask which made me shudder. Nevertheless, the priest insisted on granting us a gift to mark the beginning of a close relationship. We would ask about the tribe. I wanted to know more about the culture of these people. Delicately, I inquired about the nature of their traditions and customs. Gesturing grandly, they told me of their mighty god, responsible for both bountiful times and catastrophes. He inspired love and awe in equal measure. The islanders gave me the blessing of their mighty god before sending me on their way. On our way. We would eat some of the pale purple jelly. Then continue on our way to... strange things. We found the hut of a shaman. And would trade with him. He presented his wares. We would barter, though. We had found an overgrown shamanic stuff, some beetle nuts. Oh well. It was hard to tell what we would take here. We were tending to no deal at all, but would that be good? It would have to be good enough. There was more to find, though. A shrine. A large building, tilted and subsiding. It seemed as if the ground could open to the gaping chasm at any moment. We searched for secrets inside of the temple. And found traps that we would examine. My mind becoming strangely focused, I found myself speaking words I had never heard before, chanting their strange song against my will. I lost consciousness briefly. When I came to... an inner glow suffused my being. I was blessed. Before us lay some kind of ceremonial room. Pictographs on the altar warned that the great chasm would open beneath the shrine. The treasure here were disturbed. We would look what was there and found nothing. So we left again to continue our journey to a famed mountain, maybe. We would see where everything would lead us. We marched on. finding a strange waterfall. Maybe we could rest there. What a cool the air, creating a fresh breeze, and we could rest. It was a beautiful night, and I was filled with contentment. I noticed that the green bushes framing our camp looked somehow familiar. Taking a closer look, I recognized the leaves. It was a coca plant. Knowing of their uplifting effects, I gathered what I could before we went to sleep that night. And sleep we did. As we prepared for departure, I knew we would miss the melodic tone of the falling water. Still though, we had to leave the coca leaves behind. We had found something strange, but maybe it was time before to speak with a strange being here, the Wandering Duke. When we first encountered the monstrous creature, we were afraid of what might do. We did not expect to speak. It was, however, "Are you coming to feed the Duke?" A great surprise, a voice from deep inside its many maws was requesting an offering. It would digest whatever we gave it in one of its stomachs, and we would get whatever byproducts were produced in the process. Promised that those remains could be of great use to us, but we would first try to trade. It had indeed many beautiful things here. A mooncake, chocolate, red berries, many useful items. Were hidden there. Mangoes for instant consumption was just what we wanted to do, wanted to have. We would pay in raptor hides again. Would we give him an offering? Maybe. We had some seashells and some pearls. We gave him the things and we got a supercharged cunning potion. Didn't look very appetizing, but the creature assured us of its great value. It was not about to argue. What did we have there now? We wouldn't see it. Okay, we proceeded to eat the mangoes and we had to leave the raptor hide behind. Maybe the potion would be of use to us. We ventured forward. The strange, unexplored thing to the east. Another portal. The fork swirled around me as I entered the moving bank. I wandered within it for what seemed an eternity. When I finally got my bearings, I saw that the fork had settled densely on my position. Quickly, I hurried to escape. We traveled forward and quickly approached a portal. A mysterious gate towered above us. A light swirling at its center seemed to form some type of portal. And we entered it. We had no other option. Once more we stepped through a portal, this time hoping it would take us back where we came from. Stepped out of the portal, I soon recognized the terrain around us. We had made it back. I let out a sigh of relief. Although I knew I could not rest for long, we still had an expedition to finish. Oh yeah. We still had to find something for our ship. And maybe Beating the beast shaman was the way to do that. Move into the Tar Borg. It fled from us, though. Oh, come on, freaking shaman. Went away and away. We had to resort to our food cans. The shaman wanted to avoid us, but not anymore. Protected ourselves. Then went on to attack. The shaman would be the first to be struck. Steeled ourselves. We knew taking out the shaman was what we had to do, and so we did exactly that. The raptors would not take us down so massively. And to our surprise, we were right. Put our protection up again. Hit the raptor. Again. And again. Struck the last beast down and checked the dead for valuables. Getting a lot! We had to take the headdress of the shaman so we would have proof of his demise. The beast would terrorize the locals no longer. Now I only needed to return to the village to claim my reward. Which reward? Yes. I had to drop a lot, but quickly, maybe, we could return to the strange village. With the help of some cans, maybe. Was a dense thing. Another strange shaman seemed to have appeared there. Nevertheless, we approached the village. The islanders were delighted by my presence, and we went on. The beast had been vanquished. I showed my proof and was rewarded well for my trouble. Emerged from the hood, blinking rapidly as my eyes adjusted to the light outside. We looked if they would have anything to help us with our ship, but to no avail. We would have to rest with them. The islanders, though, invited us to sit with them. Marlin asked the locals that night about the Palikao, wanting to know of the indigenous histories had more knowledge of them. They muttered among themselves, seeming unwilling to speak of the issue. They would only say that the Palikao were dangerous, their works to be avoided at any cost. Marlin pressed further, determined to know more, but was met with a stony silence. We would not sleep well that night. But we rested, and rested more indeed. My time with the friendly islanders was a delight. He still had that hide shield and wondered who should take it, but Malin didn't want to, surprisingly. So we went on to trade with the villagers, gave them that ugly headdress and the hide shield, and looked what we could get for this. Maybe just their goodwill would be enough. We would rest again. One of the villagers looked very concerned. She appeared to ask for my name. Thinking it harmless, I answered. As she heard it, she grew more upset still. Shaken, the islander said that a man named Henri Durand had warned them about me, calling me a villain. Durand, my former companion, successfully tarnished my reputation, it appeared. Goodness, no! Then we left the village. They were suspicious of us. One islander clasped my hand in respect and wished me farewell, though. We knew that further to the east something was hidden, and we went there, past the dinosaur nest. There was, though, another dinosaur nest. Now, everything grew dark. The question was where we would find something, anything, to fix our ship. There was one more thing that maybe could help us. We ran. A over lava and wretched sulfur we went. To the strange elephant graveyard. As I approached the bone-strewn landscape, I was surprised by a loud trumpeting noise. It seemed like I wasn't alone after all. They would search and avoid elephants. And it worked. We found elephant tusks but left them behind, as they would help us nothing at all. We would have to go further to find something for our ship. Unknowing what it would be, we marched directly to a tar bog. Could imagine that with tar, maybe the things would be fixed. We didn't know at all what could help us, and maybe these were the last steps we would make. Our last chance were the Polykao ruins. We were attacked by a beastly shaman. With massive force. I would have to act quickly and decisively. Made Miss Cutley heal a bit. And hoped for the best. They attacked us with relentless force. Heal ourselves still. At any cost! Sank down, defeated. Dinosaur would have to bleed. Then we hit the shaman. Time to protect us, though, at any cost. We struck him down and checked him for valuables. We had a lot of things with them, but none of them would help us. Left the moonstone. And the raptor hides. Send Joby out to search something. Got us some strengthening mushrooms, interestingly. Which help us carry our packs. Approached the ruins in a last ditch. The ancient Polycarp structures had long been torn to rubble. Their shapes were ruined and twisted. The smooth surface is marred by ugly scorch marks. I found an ancient tablet in the rubble that told of their history. It showed how the Being Engine had brought a miraculous age of prosperity to all. The different peoples of the islands had been moved from their own lands to enjoy the bounty of the Polycarp's offerings, enjoying a life of peaceful harmony. She nodded meaningfully at the story of the tablet. She had a fervent gleam in her eye, clearly picturing the same bright future for our own people. Oh well. We had to repair. Nothing remained there. Nothing. Nothing at all. Our hope was lost. The fog came closer. We were lost in that strange land. Where nothing would help. We would have tried with tar, but tar also wouldn't help. Approached a pirate ship. I returned to the old ship, but we couldn't repair it. We rested for a last rest. Kezia Young was hobbling now. We drank and drank. Wouldn't know what we could do. I was awakened by a deep and dangerous buzzing. Looking around, I saw Homie flailing wildly, trying to defend himself against giant wasps. Should I help him get rid of the annoying things? Or mind my own business? We would try to help. Moving with grace and purpose, I made short work of the small swarm of giant wasps. Homie thanked me sincerely and went to bed, exhausted. 7 in one stroke, just like the story. nearly been there for a year. Or even longer. We left. Again. Hopeless. Jim Ball had detected absolutely nothing. I had to look at the destroyed portal at least again. Maybe we would find something there. However, we moved there. It didn't really seem to matter, though. Something to caulk the seams. Was nothing at all. We moved onward. Then stopped. There were strange planes with weird structures on them. The truffle hog dug an obsidian shard out, though. Interestingly, that would also not repair the ship. We went to another waterfall in search of solutions. While the fog came closer. Homie's injuries developed into an infection. We approached the waterfall hoping that it would help to heal. We rested. Kizia Young seemed to be angry about our dinner arrangement. She accused Homie of eating more than his fair share of rations, leaving Young starved. Homie denied any of this. How should I settle this dispute? Oh, I can only take her side. Homie always did have a gluttonous streak. I would restrict the rations of Homie and give them to Young. Yeah, we were in love, though, so it was clear what happened here. These were maybe the last things that I would that I would write in this diary. As we made our last tries to reach something that would help. Looked to trade. What could we find? A giant feather? Horn flute? A bait? Certainly not. Maybe some meat, that was about it. I gave him the ugly headdress for it. Ate some burned meat. Decided to head for one of the dinosaur nests again through the ugly fog. Would we find something there still? I found something unexpected there. One of the items I needed to repair the ship. It was a simple cauldron of tar, useful for waterproofing a ship. While less impressive than the previous two repair items, it was exactly what I needed. Now all that remained was to return to the old pirate ship, make my repairs, and leave this wretched place. I had to camp for a bit. Otherwise we wouldn't make it through. Rest. A lone figure approached camp. I was shocked to see that it was Henri Durand. We had not parted on good terms. Humbly asked to join my trek once more. What had happened to him out there to make him return? No, we were full. We had to send him away. I drew my weapon and chased him out of the camp. In a time of need, they come back. But now is our time of need. I needed to leave again and cure Homie. He was really happy, and we had to see where we could go. We used our scroll. Of random teleportation. And went forward big time. We knew that the ship was somewhere out there and ran to it with force. Power and determination. We would have to run through the fog. We approached the old pirate ship. It rocked slightly. We repaired it. We worked for many days to repair the ship. Hard manual labor exhausted our bodies. But puzzling out the Palikao technology left us mentally shattered. Our repairs complete, we then felled the number of logs that we'd used as rollers placed under the ship, allowing us to painstakingly drag it across the ground. Finally, after weeks of backbreaking work and a number of unprintable words that would astound even the Royal Navy, we launched our ship into the water, and it was time to sail home. We were surprised we had made it. The Royal Avalon Society, though, was very happy about our return. We had collected so many things that they and we also would be seen as glorious explorers. Also the crystals that the society had wanted were there in great numbers. Continued to Paris, relieved. Seeing how much it had helped us, we would continue our studies in becoming a medic and returned to Paris once more. All of Paris was alight with talk of my majestic new ship and the incredible artifacts we had donated to the expo, the key staff and the great crystal. I was overjoyed, but I could see that Victoria was not satisfied. To her expedition had been a failure, and she would not rest until she found the being engine. Her face a mask of determination, she asked me to continue my explorations of the isle, searching for further clues. Meanwhile, she would do her own research here in Paris. We, though, celebrated and rejoiced our healthy return to Paris. But soon we would prepare for another expedition, but that was a story for another time. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. This is Manuel Khan signing out. See you soon and happy gaming.